Inner Sanctum Mystery, starring Senator Satrega, brought to you by the makers of Carter's Little Liverpool, the best friends to your sunny disposition.
Good evening, friends. This is Raymond, your host for the Inner Sanctum. Yes, it's bidding you welcome once again. Come in. Make yourselves comfortable. That is, as comfortable as you can around this very strange man we're going to introduce to now. Yes, he's quite a character. Someone who hates you, one and all. Oh, but don't be alarmed. There are plenty of others here just as frightened as you. So do join us, because misery loves company.
Inner Sanctum Mysteries brings you one of radio's best known stars, Mr. Santos Ortega. Tonight, Mr. Ortega appears as Gerald Hagen in Death as Floor, an original radio drama by Sigmund Miller, presented for your entertainment by the makers of Carter's Little Liverpool, the laxative with the two-way action. Everybody knows what the name Carter's Little Liverpool means. That's why, for over 60 years, folks have bought them and taken them with confidence whenever a gentle, efficient laxative was needed. Yes, and they've known, too, that the name Carter's Little Liverpools also means added help, because they wake up the flow of a very important digestive juice. When this juice flows at the rate nature intended, it helps tone up the digestive system so that most folks can lose that marked down, grumpy, listless feeling that so often accompanies sluggish, lazy digestion. So take advantage of this time-tested two-way relief. And always ask your druggist for genuine Carter's Little Liverpool, the best friend to your sunny disposition.
The early hours of the morning in the backyard of a tenement house on Bailey Street. Turk, one of the tenants, has just rushed downstairs from his apartment in a fury. For the third night in succession, his sleep has been disturbed by a cat howling in the alley.
I'll bash your head. You're not going to break up my sleep anymore.
That's sweet.
Oh, hello. Didn't expect to find anyone here at this hour. You're Mr. Hagen, aren't you?
Yes, Mr. Church. Whom do you intend to kill with that bat?
Those blasted cats. I haven't been able to sleep for 3 nights. I'm all worn out.
I wouldn't do that if I were you, Mr. Church. It isn't right to take the life of a defenseless animal.
Defenseless? What about me? My sleep is more important than the miserable life of one of these pets.
Bad luck to kill a cat.
Bad luck, my eye. Oh, I get it. You're the guy who keeps a house full of cats.
I have 3 cats.
I don't care how many cats you have or whose pet they are. They ain't going to howl anymore in this yard when I'm through with them.
I warn you, Mr. Kirsch, to leave those cats alone. I tell you, it's bad luck to kill any of these beautiful creatures.
Oh, crackpot. Can't argue with a crackpot. To me, cats are disgusting. Can't even bear to touch them.
The most beautiful creatures in the world.
Maybe they are to you, but they won't be so beautiful after I get through with them.
You had better go back to sleep and leave the cats alone.
Go back to sleep yourself. Oh, what are you doing up at this hour anyway?
I had a premonition that Apollo was in danger.
Who the devil is Apollo?
My silver gray Persian. The fur of the finest texture.
Oh, you're nuts, Mr. Hagen. I'm going to get those cats if it takes all night.
Go back to your apartment, you fool, before it's too late.
There they are.
Go, Mr. Kirsch.
I'll miss them, but I am going to get them.
Strike at them again.
Let me go.
I warned you.
I won't.
To leave them alone. You'd kill my cats, would you? You'll never call them that again.
Kill anyone else who dares to lay a hand on my beloved friend.
Cool. You're my enemy. I must be clever. What was your husband doing in the yard?
I told him not to go downstairs. He wouldn't listen. Jack was driving him crazy. He couldn't
sleep. Did anybody hate your husband? Was he ever threatened?
Hate him? No, he hated my Danny. He never bothered anyone. He was a good, hard-working husband.
Do you know what time he left the house?
About 2.
And when did you go down to look for him?
3 o'clock. I couldn't understand what kept him. He was lying in the yard on his back. His eyes open. I screamed. I got in and ran away after that. Oh, Danny.
Come on, Sergeant. We'll go through the rest of the house. We're going to investigate every tenant in this building. This isn't a robbery. The wallet was found alongside the body. No thief would stop to empty a wallet. Anyone who committed a murder would get away from the scene as fast as he could. Let's go, Sergeant. We'll start from the first floor and work our way up.
Scratch on your hand. Where did you get it?
If you look closely, you'll see that it's a few days old.
I didn't kill Mr. Kirk. I have no reason to kill him or anyone else. I'm a peaceful, law-abiding citizen.
Did you know Mr. Kirk?
Not very well. I nodded to him whenever I saw him.
Mr. Hagen, do you live alone?
Yes.
What do you do for a living?
I'm retired.
All right, Hagen, I guess that's all right now.
Good night, officer. I hope you find a criminal.
We will.
Why don't you look where you're going? You stepped on my cat's tail.
Hey, wait a minute. Sam Kurtz was killed trying to get rid of the farm cats which have been disturbing his sleep. Your cat might have been one of them. Very possible. You love cats, don't you?
Yes, I'm quite fond of them. I have two.
So, you have three.
That's right. There are four or five other families in this tenement who keep cats. I guess there are millions of people who own them as pets. There's nothing strange or queer about keeping pets.
Nothing strange about keeping a pet. For three is something different. I'm going now, but I'll be back. There's nothing I can pin on you, but somehow I feel that you know more than you appear to know. We'll look into this more thoroughly later. Good night.
Working on the Kirsch murder case a little long. murdered man's money was discovered near the spot where the body was found, torn to shreds. Residents of Bailey Street are asked to cooperate with the police by reporting any suspicious character immediately and to take extra precautions until the criminal is apprehended. The man may be a deranged killer. And now the sports. The Boston...
Good heavens, a madman. Bobby, come here.
Yes,
ma'am. It's time for you to go to bed, darling. I have a surprise for you. How would you like to sleep in Mommy's bed?
With you, Mommy?
Yes, darling. Both of us together. And you can have a holiday tomorrow.
And I don't have to go to school?
No, you can stay home with Mommy all day. Bobby, come here.
Why is my hand cold, Mommy?
What's happening in this house now?
Open that door.
Who's there?
Me. Just got a telephone call that a suspicious-looking fellow was seen going into this house. You hear anybody walking past the door?
Yes, someone seemed to be in a hurry.
Which way'd he go?
Well, it seemed to me as if he were going upstairs. Then I'm not sure, but I thought I heard footsteps in the vacant apartment directly above me.
Thank you, ma'am.
This one off. Four seats. Hey, back in there, I'm telling you.
I'm liable
to
get hurt. Oh,
here
you are, sir. Katie downstairs, she heard footsteps in the empty apartment.
Better
take a look.
All right. Keep your gun ready.
You don't know who's in there.
You in there? Come on out.
Just turn the knob and push the door open.
Look through the rest of the apartment.
Guess there's no one here.
Wait. The window's open. Leads to the roof. You go around through the hallway. I'll go through the fire escape. Did you notice anything?
No, but this roof has plenty of places to hide.
Just a minute. There's something behind that ledge.
Here. Yeah, I hear something.
Come on out or we'll shoot. Shoot at the first thing that moves from that ledge. It's only a cat. Oh, we killed it. Too bad. We can't take any chances with the dangerous killer on the loose. Come on, we'll take another look around.
My cat.
Huh?
What have they done to my cat?
Oh, it's you, Hagen. What are you doing here?
I heard my cat scream. What have you done to him?
Well, we shot him by accident.
Apollo, my beautiful Apollo, you heartless butcher.
Take it easy, Hagen, and watch your tongue. We didn't mean to kill your cat. We just aren't taking chances with a dangerous killer on the loose.
My poor Apollo, dead. I wouldn't let you live. I wouldn't.
Where are you going with that cat?
Leave me alone. You've done your job.
Better call the SPCA or the Department of Sanitation to get rid of that dead animal.
Department of Sanitation? You think my cat is just refuse? We got rid of like a pail of garbage? It was a living and beautiful animal. A moment ago it had a life, a heart, consciousness, feelings, dignity. Its life was as important to it as your life is to you. How dare you call it garbage?
I didn't call it anything.
Let me pass. I'm taking my cat to my room.
You'd better get rid of it fast before it begins to deteriorate.
That's my business!
He is a queer egg, that guy. Queer enough to do anything.
Unfeeling descendants of hate dragged you. I lay you down on your favorite cushion. They killed you. Your life meant nothing to them. Nothing at all. To them, you were only a cat. Another animal. What do they know of your superb grace? Exquisitely and highly.
gracefully you walk, keeping your head erect with dignity. See you, Empress. And you, Sheba. My only remaining friend. They've killed our Apollo. No more will he sit in my lap. No more will I stroke his rich glossy fur. I'm never to hear its sweet purring again.
The pace of his authority. I shan't go unpunished. I swear to you. I'll wipe that murderer from the face of the earth. I'll kill him by degrees.
Let him feel the torture suffering of slow suffocation.
I'll squeeze the breath from him until he begs with his eyes for pity. Until the muscles crack in his throat. Until his brow becomes damp with the cold touch of death. I promise you, Sheba, Empress, I won't rest until you're dead. Dead by my own two hands.
Hagen. Who? Hagen, your next door neighbor. Oh, how are you?
Sorry, I'm here to wait, Mr. Hagen, but I'm so nervous in this place.
You can't be too sure in this house anymore. Every time I hear a knock on the door, my heart jumps into my mouth.
I don't think there's anything more to worry about.
You don't think the maniac will come back?
I don't think it was a maniac, Mr. Justin.
You don't? Well, what makes you think?
Oh, I don't know. I just think.
Mr. Hagen, I heard about the cat being killed last night. It's a shame. He was such a beautiful animal and so smart.
He killed my pet in cold blood.
Oh, I hate them,
though. Terrible, I know, but I wouldn't hate them. After all, they didn't mean to do it.
All I know is that they shot Apollo. I'm worried about my other cat, Sheba. Have you seen her doll today?
Yes, she was in the hall a little while ago. Oh, I tell you, Mr. Hagen, this house is giving me a nervous breakdown. I haven't let Bobby go to school for 2 days. I'm afraid I don't know what to do. I have so much shopping to do, and I'm afraid to leave him alone. Tell me, would it be too much trouble, Mr. Hagen, if I asked you to stay with Bobby while I did some shopping?
Well, of course, Mrs. Jackson. I'd love to watch him for you.
Oh, thank you so much.
And the door?
I'll just get my purse. I won't be more than 15 minutes.
That's all right. No need to worry. There's nothing special to do anyway.
Oh, here's the cat now. It just walked in.
Oh, here you are, my darling Sheba. Been hiding in the hall, haven't you?
Now, you be a good boy, Bobby. Don't get Mr.
Good, Mommy.
So you're having a holiday, are you, Bobby?
Yes, Mr. Hagen. Mine wants me to stay home.
What class are you in?
I'm 1A4, certain first or second C.
Oh, that's very good. You know any forms?
Oh, yeah, I know. Hickory Dickory Dock.
Let me hear it.
Oh.
Come on, don't be shy. I'll tell you what, if you recite a poem, I'll recite one also.
You promise?
Yes, I promise.
Right. Hickory dickory dock, the mouse ran out the clock. The clock struck one, and down he ran. Hickory dickory dock.
Very good.
Now you recite.
All right. Pussycat, pussycat, where have you been? I went to London to see the Queen. Pussycat, pussycat, what did you there? I frightened a little mouse under
her chair. Why? Tell me more.
All right, you know this one. Ding dong bell. Pussy's in the well.
Please, you already recited one about a cat. Now tell me one about a dog.
Don't you like cats?
Oh, I like dogs best. I wish I had a dog.
They're disgusting.
Well, I like dogs 100 times better than cats.
Keep quiet, you little fool. What do you know about cats? Nothing at all.
Are you mad at me, Mr. Hagen?
I don't like little boys who don't know what they're talking about.
Oh, here, you pussy, here, pussy, here, pussy.
Let go of her tail.
Oh, look at me. I can see that girl by the neck.
Get your hands off of your little brat. Just like the rest of your breed, I'll take care of you. You'll never hurt me again.
What are you doing to my boy? Are you crazy?
Torment my cat, will you?
Keep your hands off me.
Leave
either of you were there.
And my cats again.
No one's going to save you. Stop there, you. Don't come any nearer.
I've got a knife.
Any of you come any closer? Wind
up here.
Right. And when you don't feel good, try Carter's Little Liver Pills. They do the work of calomel, but have no calomel in them. For they are simple pills made of vegetable drugs. They wake up the flow of one of our most vital digestive juices. When this vital juice flows at the rate of about 2 pints a day, it helps to digest our food and bring back the glorious feeling that goes with regularity. Then most folks feel like happy days are here again. But be sure you get the genuine Carter's Little Liver Pills. 25 cents at all the stores. This is the Blue Network, operated by the National Broadcasting Company.